Good morning, everybody. Sorry about getting the video up so late. For some reason, I wasn't able to upload or do anything at work. All right, we're going to try to go over some work today, 10-6 and 10-7. I don't have the practice test in front of me, so I'm going to come up with some problems. Notice that you have a test Monday on these two sections. The practice test is on portal. You can print your own copy. The answers are there. Homework is due, all work from last week, and I want you to rework all problems for credit. Remember, you're trying to learn, and that's our goal.
All right, 10.7. They're talking about circles. And if you take an angle, and let's say this angle right here is 40 degrees, that means this angle has to be 360 minus 40. So that angle has to be 320 degrees, because it's got to add up to 360. Now, here's the deal. If they want to know the measure of arc AB, the measure of arc AB would be the same as the angle. So the measure of arc AB would be 40. However, the arc length, how long it actually is, how long it is from here to here, distance from there to there, you would have to use the formula fraction times circumference. So the fraction is 40 over 360 times pi times diameter. Now I'd have to give you some kind of diameter. So let's say the radius is 7, so the diameter would be 14. You would multiply and then divide by 360. Do it on your calculator. Copy all of this down. Now, on the other hand, if they wanted to know the area of the sector, like a slice of pizza, you would still take the fraction, but only this time you would use area, which is pi radius squared. So there's a difference between the radius and the diameter. Circumference is pi times diameter, and that is the distance around the circle, is circumference. So if you were going to go around it 5 times, you would multiply 5 times circumference. So that would be 5 times pi times diameter. That would give you 5 laps around. All right, the only other thing I want to talk about is this. Let's say you have a circle, you have an area of a sector, and they want to find the slither, this little outside piece here. We'll call it a slither. To do that, you would do the area of the sector minus the triangle. Let's make this 30 degrees, make this radius 8. And we're going to do the area of the sector. So it's going to be the fraction times pi radius squared, 8 times 8, minus the triangle. To do the triangle, you're going to do side times side, 8 times 8, times the sine of the included angle, which is the one in between, divide it by 2. Now, I don't have a calculator here at home, but this is the formula. You would square it, multiply, multiply, divide by 360, and get a number. You would do the sine of 30, press equals, make sure you press equals, times 64, divide it by 2, and you would get another answer, and then subtract, and you got that slither.
All right, again, this is all I'm going to post this weekend. I'm sorry that I can't post any Saturday homework, but go to the practice test and work those. Plus, I have some bonuses on there. Give it your best shot. Have a good morning. This has been another edition of Mr. Toops's Classroom.